This is an algebraic problem. So we want to solve it now. But before we start, I'll use this medium to appreciate my subscribers, both old and new, and also appreciate my viewers. Please, I will appreciate my viewers if they do well to subscribe, like, comment, and share the video. So now let's begin with this, the solution of this problem. So now let's start. Now we have 449 to the 4x minus 25 to the 4x is equal to 35 to the 4x. So now this 49 is 7 to the 4x, 4 to the 4x minus this is 25 is 5 to the 4x, 4 to the 4x, 35 is 5 times 7, all to the 4x. Now divide all through by 5 to the power 2x. So now we have 5 to the power 2x divided by 5 to the power 2x divided by 5 to the power 2x. So here you have 7 to the power 7 divided by 5 all to the power 2x. Now minus this, we cancel out, they're the same. We have 1. This will now be equal to, here you have 5 times 7. No, sorry, this can also be, this can be written as 5 to the power x, 7 to the power times 7 to the power x divided by 5 to the power x times 5 to the power x. This is the same thing as that. So now, according to the law of indices, if you have 5, let's say a to the power 2x is the same thing as a to the power x times a to the power x. So this is the law of indices. So that is what we apply here. So this will cancel out this. Now this can also be rearranged as 7 to the power x all divided by 5 to the power x all to the power 2 minus 1 is equal to 7 to the power x all divided by 5 to the power x. Now coming to this point, you can now say let p be equal to 7 to the power x divided by 5 to the power x. So now substituting, anywhere we see this, we substitute for p. So we have p squared minus 1 is equal to p. So p squared minus, bringing this p to this other side, you have p squared minus p minus 1 is equal to 0. Now using the quadratic formula, where since a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 1, c is equal to minus 1. That means p is equal to minus b plus or minus the square root of b, square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Applying this, you have p is equal to minus minus 1 plus or minus the square root of minus 1 square minus 4 times 1 times minus 1 all divided by 2. So you have this minus times minus 1 will give you 1 plus or minus the square root of 1 plus 4 divided by 2. So you have 1 plus or minus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Now here you have plus 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2 or 1 minus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Since this one is negative, we will not make use of this. That means p is equal to this. So p is equal to 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Now since p is 7 all over 5, 7 divided by 5 all to the power x equal to equal to 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2. So taking log natural log of cosine, so now we now say ln 7 divided by 5 all to the power x is equal to ln 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Now according to the law of logarithm, if you have ln a to the power b is the same thing as b ln a. So that means this can be written as x ln 7 all over 5 is equal to ln 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Now divide both sides by ln 7 all over 5. 7 divided by 5. So this will cancel out. We now have x to be equal to ln 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2 all divided by ln 7 divided by 5. So this is the final answer. Thank you for watching to the end. Have a nice day.